I'm nervous, but I'm happy to be here.
Oh, good. What's your name?
My name's Craig. Craig Ball.
And how old are you, Craig?
I'm 24.
What's brought you to Britain's Got Talent?
I've had people tell me I should come on, and I thought maybe finally I should just do it for myself, because I don't usually believe myself, but I feel like I do. For once.
I'm Craig Ball, I'm 24, and I'm from Hertfordshire. My job at the moment is maintenance in central London. I often change light bulbs, I'll do plumbing, I'll do a lot of painting as well. It's not a very interesting job.
That's like what you really want to do is win this and then just let everybody know you're asking after that.
I discovered singing when I was about 9 or 10. I feel like with my unique style, I might actually stand a chance to win Britain's Got Talent. Today is a massive day for me. Like, it's going to be the biggest performance I've ever done, but I know deep down I can do it.
Okay, take it away.
Yeah?
We clawed, we chained our hearts in vain. We jumped, but never asking why. We kissed, I fell under your spell. A love that no one could deny. What? Don't you ever say I just walked away. I will always want you.
To break your rules, all you ever did was wreck me. Yeah, you wreck me. It's slowly turn, you let me burn, and now it rushes on the ground.
Don't you ever say I just walked away. I will always want you.
I can't live a lie, running for my life. I will always want you.
Thank you, me.
Brilliantly original way to do impressions.
It is fun.
And I love that so many of those were ones you never see people do impressions of. Really, really brilliant art.
Thank you.
That was so funny, and like David said, original. And I did not expect that. Well done.
Craig, when it first started, because I didn't think you actually did sound like Morgan Freeman, I thought you were singing some tribute to him or something. And then I realised what was going on. It was current, it was clever. I think we may have discovered a big star.
Thank you so much.
So we'll vote, Simon?
It's 1,000,000% yes.
Thank you so much.
It's a yes from me. It's a yes from me.
You have 4 yeses. Congratulations.
Well done, Craig.
Well done. All the judges on their feet, all the crowd on their feet. You must be thrilled.
I'm over the moon.
Kids are going to love this act. He's brilliant.
Hey, Mum, I got 4 yeses on Britain's Got Talent.
Ow, you're down.
You're very strong.
Yeah. It's all yours.
You.
Have fun.
Another little sausage.
She's so cute.
Oh, there's going to be something in that box.
Hello.
Hello.
What's your name?
Izzy Simpson.
Nice to meet you, Izzy. How old are you?
8.
8 years old? And where are you from?
Blackpool.
Nice. So, Izzy, Izzy, tell us a little bit about yourself.
I'm going to be doing some magic. My grandpa teaches me.
So that means your grandfather is a wizard?
Yes.
Right. I've got it.
My name is Izzy Simpson and I'm 8 and I'm going to be doing some magic. I live in Blackpool and I live with my brother, my mum and my dad. I think I was born to do magic.
What do you like best about magic?
What I like best about magic is I can make everyone gasp and go, wow. When I grow up, I would like to be Hermione Granger from Harry Potter because she's a wizard. A witch. I thought that was Dumbledore. It does look like him, though. The judge I want to impress is Simon because he's the boss. If I get through, I will be pretty excited. One of the best days ever.
All right, best of luck.
Thank you. Can I come down and join you?
You can.
Today I'm going to show you something of my two favourite things, magic and reading, using my three favourite books. My first favourite author is Colin Davis, Mathemagical. Amanda, could you look through the book and see if each page is different?
Yes, darling.
My second favourite author is Enid Blyton, The Magical Faraway Tree. Alicia, could you look through the book and see if each page is different?
OK.
My third favourite author is David Wyams, The Midnight Gang. David, could you look through the book and see if each page is different?
It would be a pleasure.
Yes. While still doing that, Simon, could you pick up my box and put it on the floor for me, please?
Where?
Over there.
Very bossy.
Down here?
Yeah.
I can't lift it.
David, do you want to go and help
I him? Literally can't lift it.
We're trying together.
Go on.
To me, to you.
To me, to you.
It won't lift.
Oh, wait one minute. Could you sit back down for me, please?
All right, go sit down. Go sit down.
No, you as well.
Here's your chance.
Okay. Right, I'm back.
Simon, I want to show you a card trick, but it's a card trick.
Hang on, I'm still a bit scared after that. Give me 5 seconds. Okay.
As you can see, all the cards are different.
Yeah, I can.
I'm going to turn them face down, and I want you to touch the back of any card.
All right, that one. Thank you.
I want you to look at your card, remembering don't let anyone else see.
I won't. Okay.
Now, Simon, you're the boss. I want you to pick any book, either Amanda, Alicia or David's.
Alicia's, please.
Alicia's book has about 600 pages. Could you name a number between 1 and 600?
It's 77.
Alicia, could you turn your book to page 77 yes. for me, please? And check if all the words are different.
Yes, all the words are different.
Now, could you pick any word and tell us what it is?
Kettle.
Kettle. Remember, Sam, you could have picked any book, and Alicia, you could have chosen any word, but you chose kettle.
Yes.
See this blackboard? Before the show tonight, I wrote a word on the board. Watch.
No way.
No way.
What was your card?
It's the four of diamonds.
Simon.
What is a female wizard?
A witch.
Is it bad for me to call you a witch?
Well, not in Harry Potter.
No, that's what I'm thinking, because this is like real-life Harry Potter.
Oh!
Just amazing. You really are.
You're extraordinary. You're 8 years old. I mean, you put a lot of big grown-up magicians to shame. It's fantastic.
It was brilliant. And, yeah, your presentation was absolutely fantastic. Absolutely incredible.
You can't underestimate how brilliant this is for someone of your age, and your confidence is incredible. David.
Izzy, Wizzy, woo, it's a yes from me.
It's a yes from me, Izzy.
Definitely yes from me, well done.
I'm going to say yes.
Thank you.
Well done, well done. That was incredible.
Amazing.
How was it?
Good.
You are seriously spooky. And we could not lift the box.
My name is Billy, and this is my sister, Emily.
Ah, fantastic. So how long have you known each other? So, Billy and Emily, how old are you guys?
I'm 28 and she's 25.
My name's Billy.
I'm Emily. We're from Birmingham.
We're brother and sister, and we are roller skaters. We started roller skating when we were kids.
I was 5 and my brother was 8. Our mother, she saw on TV some roller skaters and she thought, oh, that's elegant and safe and something nice that we can do together. So she bought us roller skates and from that moment on, we were hooked.
I love skating with my sister. I will not skate with anyone else.
He's my big brother and I've always looked up to him. I'm performing with my best friend. Today, we want to make our parents proud and we're going to give it our all.
We're going to try and put on a great show, and hopefully the judges and the audience will love it.
Take it away, the stage is yours.
Thank you.
Like, I was so worried for your head. You're fearless and like a fresh spin on roller skating. I thought it was fantastic.
Felt dangerous and fresh.
So I congratulate you for winning something so exciting to roller skating and to Britain's Got Talent.
And you know, I've seen a lot of roller skating acts on this show. Normally they are horrific, because you kind of think, what can you do on a stage with roller skates? I've actually never seen an act like that in my life. I mean, it's incredible. Really incredible.
I'm going to kick this off with a big, fat yes.
Thank you.
A very, very easy yes. Well done.
Massive yes from me.
It's a big, fat yes.
Yeah. Standing ovation from the crowd and all four judges.
Oh, it's more than I could ever wish for.
It is. Thank you. Like, it's a dream come true.
Oh, it was brilliant. Good variety act. What is he going to do?
Hello.
Good evening.
How are you?
Good, thank you.
Good, good. Right, tell us a bit about yourself.
My name is Marc Mitral. I come from Paris.
Bonjour.
So what are you going to do for us today?
I have a special guest for you.
Okay.
Can I invite?
Sure.
Yeah. Just for you, Miss Wendy. Come on.
Oh, Wendy!
Down here. Sit down. Okay, you can't fall down. Don't worry.
That dog was cute.
Isn't she lovely?
Hello, I am Marc Mitral. I am 61 and I come from Paris.
How are you feeling about today?
Well, you know, when you work with a live dog, it's always...
Anything can happen.
Yeah, fragile.
I grew up in a little village in France and my parents was peach farmers.
It was a hard life.
If you like peach, I can bring you a good one.
So what kind of dog is Wendy?
It's a Rottweiler.
I have this dog since he has 2 months. Without air, I will be nothing.
You think about your audition? Everything going to be all right, no?
Yeah. Vivian, my wife, she told me you are crazy to make Britain Got Talent. But to play in front of royal family, for me, it's like a dream. I'm always dreaming, even at my age.
Whenever you're ready.
Hey, you can say good evening. You speak English? It's my night. Come on, hey, say something.
No.
What, why not? It's fantastic, come on. It's presency Dutch.
Yes.
Oh my God.
No, no, listen, English?
Si.
Spanish?
Oui.
Français.
Okay.
Okay. Hey, Wendy, listen to me. You think I am stupid?
Yes.
This is brilliant! I want one!
So, well, you don't want to speak anymore?
No.
Okay. And now?
Oh, yes, I want.
You know how to sing?
No.
What?
Yes, yes, yes.
Good. Okay. Well, we'll listen to you.
Meow.
It's bow wow, eh? You understand?
Meow. Yeah.
Music, please. We're gonna sing something for you, all right? Okay, don't look at me. Look at the audience, like that. Feelings, come on. Nothing more.
Nothing
more.
No.
Trying to forget. All together, okay?
No.
Please, come on. You say it's pretty good talent, okay? All together. Feelings.
Aye, aye.
Feeling.
Oh my God.
Some people in life turn for money.
is it?
What's her name?
Wendy. Of
Wendy.
Try and listen when they're doing the act.
Well, I'm emotional.
He's immobile. He's waited a long time for this moment. For 9 years, Simon has said he wanted a dog that could meow or sing. And your dog did both those things. I mean, you're making television history here with this.
Wow. I don't know how she does that, how you taught her to do it, but it was incredible.
Oh, thank you so much.
How does she know the words?
She's very clever.
It's an incredible act, and one we're never going to forget, Mark. Well done.
Thank you very much.
Fantastic act, Mark. Really something special. Right, David.
Well, this is a very easy yes.
It's a yes from me. It's a yes from me.
You've got 4 big fat yeses.
Congratulations!
That was fantastic.
That was brilliant. Well done.
Unbelievable. How can you get a dog to do that?
Brilliant, Mark.
Thank you so
Thanks
much.
Thanks for coming.
Thank you.
We found a dog who sang and talked.
Well,
we found a dog that can sing.
No, we haven't.
I love that Simon's telling everyone.
Lauren, are you sitting down?
Yeah.
A dog came in and sang.
Well, it didn't.
Oh, my God. Are you serious?
I swear, and meowed.
Well, you was fantastic.
He is amazing.
The dog can't actually meow.
It's sad.
What song are you going to sing for us today?
I'm going to be singing She's Always a Woman by Billy Joel.
All right, we'll wish you luck.
Thank you very much.
She can kill with a smile, she can wound with her eyes. She can ruin your faith with her casual lies. And she only reveals what she wants you to see. Yes, she hides like a child, but she's always a woman to me. She just changes her mind. She'll promise you more than the Garden of Eden. That she'll carelessly cut you and laugh while you're bleeding. But she'll bring out the best and the worst you can be. Blame it all on yourself, 'cause she's always a woman to me. Changes her mind. She's frequently kind and she's suddenly cool. She can do as she pleases, she's nobody's fool. And she can't be convicted, she's earned her degree. Blame it all on yourself, 'cause she's always a woman to me.
Welcome to Britain's Got Talent.
Thank you.
What's your name?
I'm Maya Goff.
And how old are you, Maya?
I'm 12 years old.
It's a beautiful dress. I nearly wore that dress today, actually. Lucky I didn't. Whereabouts are you from?
I'm from South Wales.
She seems sweet.
Who's with you today?
I got a lot of family with me today. I've got my mum, my dad, my sister, my auntie, my uncle, my grandma, my grandpa, my cousins. Yeah.
So all of Wales, basically. I guess you're going to sing for us today.
Yes.
So who's your biggest singing idol?
Whitney Houston. I'm singing a Whitney Houston song today, and I just love Whitney Houston.
Okay, well, we wish you all the best, Maya.
Thank you.
You
ready, yeah?
Yeah, man.
It's all yours.
Good have luck! Fun.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Oleg. I represent Team Udi tonight.
What's Team Udi?
Team Udi is a dance team.
Are you in Team Udi?
They are my big friends.
So you're not in the group, you're
no,
their friend?
No, just a okay. friend, yeah.
And so you're like their translator?
Something like this, yeah.
And where are they from?
From Siberia, Tomsk.
We are UDI,
Dance Team UDI.
From Tomsk,
Siberia.
Uh-huh. We are UDI, we are from Tomsk, Siberia.
Dance Team, this is our friend.
Dancing is our life.
UDI is a big friendly family.
In Siberia, we run own dance school for underprivileged kids. We work closely with the local orphanage to give the children a sense of belonging. This is a matter of great honor for us.
If UDI win the Britain's Got Talent, they want to build a big, big school.
Today means everything to us. If the British public gets behind us, it could change our lives and the children's lives forever.
We want to impress.
We want to impress British peoples and judges. Yes!
Okay, well, good luck.
Thank you very much.
Nice to meet you, Oleg.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye.
Oleg, you were wonderful. You stole it for me, you know? We always say we're looking for something we've never seen before on Britain's Got Talent, and I've never seen anything like that. Wow.
Oh my goodness, visually one of the best things I think I've ever seen. Like, that was absolutely perfect. I'm almost at a loss for words. It just felt so brilliant.
Sometimes we're asked why we have people from other countries entering, but I'm so happy that we do have that, because then we get to see artists as fantastic as you.
A humongous yes.
It's a yes from me. It's a yes from me.
You've got four big fat guys.
Hi.
Welcome to Britain's Got Talent. What's your name?
My name's Shakarudin, but people call me Junior.
Junior. Yeah.
How old are you, Junior?
I'm 17.
What are you going to do for us today?
I'm going to be dancing.
OK, so what got you into dance?
Well, in the past, I've had some behavioural issues, and, like, I've been dancing, like, for a long time now,
okay.
And it's really helped me grow as a person and get better, so... I'm really, really nervous today. This is, like, the biggest performance I've ever, like, I'm ever going to do. I've come a really long way. Now I have the chance to prove myself and show my family who I am. I've been waiting for this for a long time, and, like, I feel like it's a must. I have to do it. When I was at school, like, I used to struggle a lot with the work. I would feel like if I'm getting a bad grade, I can't do better. Like, I would just feel like I'm, like, a dumb kid, or I'm just not smart enough. I felt like misbehaving was, like, the only option. I used to get in a lot of trouble, got excluded a few times. I was in a bad situation. When I started dancing, it actually gave me, like, so much confidence, and I got people praising me and saying good things about me rather than being in school and messing about. But, like, I've been training every day, man. So, like, hopefully, like, it all pays off. When I am dancing, I feel free. I can just, like, tell you a story. I can talk to you. Dancing has saved me from going down a completely different road. I can imagine if I wasn't dancing, like, I don't know where I would be today.
OK. Good. The stage is yours.
do you feel right now? Is it overwhelming? Alicia, what did you think?
Do you know what? Usually that kind of thing cringes me out, but for some reason with you, it didn't at all. I couldn't take my eyes off of you. That was incredible.
Thank you.
I could see it in your eyes, what it meant to you, and all the negative things that you've obviously been through, you've now turned into a positive. It was an amazing, very different performance to anything we've seen before.
Thank you.
I have to tell you, it's one of the most incredible things I've ever seen on this show. I mean, seriously. You're going to be talked about after this performance in Tenningwood.
Thank you. I thought it was so brave of you to channel all your emotions and anger or feelings, whatever they might be, into a piece like that. And it really expands what we think dance can be. So it was incredible what you did. You should be very proud. Thank you.
We're going to vote. And I'm going to kick this off with a yes.
Junior, it's a yes from me.
It's a yes from me.
And make that four yeses.
Tremendous.
Wow.
Well
that
done.
Was amazing.
Well done, Commander.
Well, I thought that was really, like you said, he was very brave.
Yeah, it really meant a lot to him.
Yeah, well, definitely.
What a brilliant thing. Hello.
Hello.
And what's your name?
Jessie J. McParland.
And where are you from?
I'm from Ireland.
Okay. How old are you?
9.
Okay, who are you here with?
My daddy.
Okay, Pip?
Yeah.
You excited?
Yeah. I'm here with my dad today, so I am. My mummy is home looking after my 2 younger sisters. My daddy's very good at doing my hair. He even went to the hairdressers to learn how to do it right. He works as a farmer and it's not really his thing.
Team Daddy and JJ?
Yeah.
You can grab.
Being the first girl in the family, my mum and dad wanted me to be an Irish dancer.
When did you stop?
When I was 3.
6 years ago?
Yeah.
That's a long time.
I would love to impress Simon Cowell because he's the boss of One Direction. I like One Direction because I went to their concert last year, so I did. And I'm very excited for today because I've never performed in front of a big audience and I just love to be cheered on.
Okay, good luck.
Thank you.
Dinky little thing.
Good side.
Yeah,
keep on a good side.
Yeah. My God. Do you want a job as my security guard?
What made you want to do this?
I used to do ballet and I was dancing.
This is a long way from ballet.
But I didn't like it.
She's cute as hell like that.
Yeah.
As soon as that sword comes out, jump up, 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 up!
Jessica, you are one to watch in this competition. That was incredible. So impressed.
It was brilliant as an act, and I'm sure you're going to be at the Olympics one day doing karate.
Maybe in the next act, two little people could be the villains and you can beat them up.
Yeah.
I think he means us.
OK, moment of truth. David.
I'm going to say yes.
Jessica, it's a massive yes from me.
It's a yes from me.
Jessica, 4 yeses. Congratulations.
Jessica!
Well done.
Thank you.
Well done, Jessica.
Yeah.
That was brilliant.
God, you wouldn't mess with her, would you?
Unbelievable.
Well done.
See you next time. All
right, take care.
Bye bye.
So pretty.
Yes, she's special. She's really special.
Hello?
I got 4 yeses.
Oh my God, oh my God!
You're Callum, Jade's brother. Are you okay?
Yeah.
Oh, well, tell us a little bit about yourself, please.
I'm 26, I'm from Hull. And I'm singing a cover of a song by Robin.
I love Robin.
Yeah. It's Dancing on My Own, but it's a bit slower.
Okay. Whenever you're ready, good luck.
Thank you.
Somebody said you got a new friend. And does she love you better than I can? And there's a big black sky over my town. I know where I bet she's around. Stilettos and broken bottles. I'm spinning around in circles. And I'm in the corner watching you kiss her. Oh, oh, oh. And I'm right over here. Why can't you see me? Oh, oh, oh. And I'm giving it my. Lights come on, the music dies, but you don't see me standing here. I just came to say goodbye. I'm in the corner watching you kiss her. Oh, and I'm giving it. Lights come on, the music dies, but you don't see me standing here.
amazing. This is surreal.
I'm really mean that. Well done.
Oh my God, Simon!
Callum!
Hello.
Hello.
Who are you?
I'm Lewis Codling.
Hello, Lewis. Where are you from?
I'm a London boy.
London. And how old are you?
I'm 27. I'm just singing for you today.
Oh, you're singing today? Okay, brilliant. Good luck.
I've been really trying, baby. Trying to hold back this feeling for so long. And if you feel like I feel, baby, oh, come on.
Oh.
Yeah, wait a minute.
It's funny. Sorry, Norris.
Actually have me fooled.
Thanks.
Yeah, you're a very good actor. Where do you guys normally perform and gig?
We just literally put the whole show together. I've got a really dry mouth. It's...
David wants, do you want to give him some water?
Oh, David.
There we go. No problem. Well done. Well done, really good,
number.
Really good stuff, yeah? Enjoying. Really good. Let me just say, I'm not sure you really want me to take my clothes off, do you? It's not quite as nice as that.
I think, you know, we're going to have to take a vote before things get out of hand. OK, David, yes or no?
Yeah, I'm sort of on the fence. OK, it's a yes, OK.
Alicia?
It's a yes from me, guys.
Simon?
I'm going to say yes.
Yes. Come on. Four yeses, please.
And it's a big, fat, juicy yes from me.
Yes! Thank you!
Hello.
Hello.
Who are you?
We're old men grooving.
OK. Do you have jobs?
Yes, we do.
I'm an IT manager.
I'm a teacher. And I do some part-time teaching as well.
Do you think that this is something that the Queen or the Royal Family would like?
Yeah, we think they're going to love what we're doing.
OK, best of luck.
Thank you.
Imagine being their kids.
I won't dance, don't ask me. I won't dance, don't ask me.
Britain's Got Talent. It's my favourite one.
Can I ask a question? What are you going to sing?
No.
We're a dance crew.
What?
We're a dance act.
Is this serious?
No, yes, very serious.
Honestly?
Yes.
Okay.
And you think you can win this?
Yeah. Like to think so.
Show us what you can do. Good
Thank
luck.
Thank you very much.
Come on, boy band. Let's lift this roof.
Thank you.
wish you the best of luck. We can't wait to hear the song now.
Thanks.
Good luck.
Take it on?
Yes!
Come on, let's go.
Come on, man.
Hello.
Hi.
Welcome to Britain's Got Talent.
Hey.
Oh, we're here!
It's crazy. This is crazy. Thank you.
What's your name?
We are Revelation Avenue.
So how long have you guys been performing together?
We've been together since school, really. We were broken up for about 3 years, and now we've decided to come back and take to the stage. This, for us, is the biggest thing that we've done. I mean, we rehearse at my house. So, yeah, to be in here is massive for us.
Do you think that a choir can win this show?
Yes.
We had one of the worst choirs we've ever had earlier on.
We really hope you guys enjoy it, to be honest.
I hope it all goes well. We wish you the best of luck. Go for it.
Boat and make a mess. I said quietly, agreed politely.
Guess that I forgot I had a choice. I let you push me past a breaking point. I stood for nothing, but I fell for everything.
Help me down, but I got up. Already pushing off the dust. You hear my voice, you hear that sound. Like thunder gonna shake the ground. You held me down, but I got. Fighter, dancing through the fire, 'cause I am.
I just, what I loved, I think, was the sense of heart and relationship and togetherness. Just magnificent.
It's like you're all stars. You could actually all probably be solo singers, and yet you work perfectly together. It was flawless, guys. Well done.
We had one of the worst choirs we've ever had on this show, and now we've had one of the best. You on the left, your personality when you sing, it's amazing to watch, but you've got this incredible bond amongst all of you. Congratulations.
So happy for you guys, congratulations.
And you're straight through to the live semi-final.
You just wanted them to do well. There was something about, wasn't there? Yeah.
All yours. Have fun at
it. Good luck, Ed. Good luck.
Good evening.
What's your name?
My name's Christina Lennon.
Christina, why are you here?
I want to be the next Paul McKenna. I'm a comedy stage hypnotist.
Can you hypnotise someone to be a nice person? Is that possible?
Can you hypnotise somebody to stop being really annoying?
How long is this going to go on?
Not long. OK, well, look, why don't you just get on with the act?
I am actually only one half of the act. I'm the assistant.
Oh, OK, so you're not the person who's actually...
hypnotising, no. I've got the master hypnotiser.
OK.
This is Princess the Hypno Dog.
No way.
Hang on. You are telling me that that dog is a hypnotist?
I am indeed.
Hypno Dog?
My name's Christina Lennon, and this is Princess. And today, we're going to be hypnotising volunteers from the audience.
This is Princess, she's a girl.
Yes.
Don't look into her eyes, don't look into her eyes too much.
She's the world's only hypno dog.
What does it involve then?
She looks into people's eyes and they just fall asleep.
We've actually had instances that at the wrong moment where she's looked at somebody and they've fallen out of the seat or gone to sleep. So now we tend to keep her out of the way until she's needed. Going to show them something that they've never seen before. The world's only canine hypnotist.
Okay, I've got to see this.
I need some volunteers from the audience. Let's have a look. Yep, you guys there, that row there. Do you want to come take a seat? Couple more seats, guys.
Us two.
Come on, you know you want to.
We're gonna get hypnotized by a dog. Come on, come on, come on.
Oh, he's scared, man.
He's scared.
to five, you'll all be wide awake. As soon as I ask you to count, you'll find the number seven does not exist. On the count of five, wide awake. One, two, three, four, and wide awake. Wide awake. Do you want to take a seat back in your places? Do you want to count from 1 to 10 for me, please?
Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10, 11.
Try, 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 try.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10, 11.
OK. Give them a round of applause.
Dick, are you up? Will you be quarterback, Dick?
8, 9, 10, 11.
Yeah, I don't know what was going on there. Alicia.
What the hell is going on? What have you done to our aunt and Dick?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8.
Well, she's amazing, and I think Paul McKenna has got a problem.
Did you believe it, Simon?
Well, I did at the end, yeah. I mean, I think if you're going to do this, I think you've got to get them to do more crazy things.
Yeah, this was more to show you what the dog can do.
Would you do it with to me?
Yes.
Welcome to the stage. Here we go.
I'd kneel down if I were you.
That's a first for a start.
Can you hypnotise someone to be a nice person? To be a nice person?
This is the clip they'll use when they know you've finally lost your mind.
Well, nothing's happening.
I don't think you can hypnotise everyone.
Just a normal dog.
What happened?
Well, just like a dog with a huge tongue staring at me.
Right, we're going to take a vote, yes or no.
David, yes or no?
I'm intrigued and I'm going to say yes.
I am interested in seeing what else you could possibly do, so I am a little bit on the fence about it. But I think I'm going to say yes today.
I'm going to say yes.
Hello, Simon. Simon?
Yes for me.
Thank you, thank you.
Well done.
Well done.
Are you awake?
I'm yawning.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10, 11. You've got to change this.
Yeah.
You're the best. You're the best, and you're the best, David.
That dog's done something to you, 100%.
Hello. What's your name?
My name is Jamie Raven.
Hello, Jamie Raven.
Hello.
How old are you?
I am 31.
And where are you from?
Originally from Hammersmith, but I now live... I now live in Ascot with my wife.
Can I ask you what you're doing today?
I'm a magician. My earliest memory of watching magic was probably about 10 or 11. We were on a family holiday and we were out in a restaurant and they had a magician who came over and he did his act. I thought it was amazing. That was it, and it would spark something that, you know, 20 years later would bring me here today. I live at home with my wife, Ashley. She's the best thing that ever happened to me, and everything I do, everything is for her. When we first met, we were at the bar, and I said, oh, I'll get you a drink. And she had a £5 note, so I folded it up and changed it into a £50 note and paid for it, and it was all the money I had in the world. That was one thing that won her over, the prospect of, yeah, £50 notes. Little did she know that was the only one that she'd see for the next 8 years. Over the years, I've performed in pubs, I've done clubs, I've done the darkest rooms, the loudest rooms. You know, it is a slog. I just want them to see the decades, basically, of practice and what I know I can do. So I'm excited and nervous in myself, but I want to do the best that I can do. Today could change everything. To actually do the Royal Variety as a performer, you made it.
OK.
Good luck.
Go on, mate.
May I come and join you at your table? Would that be okay? I'd like to share with you a trick. It uses a £50 note,
one of the largest currency notes available in this country. With my sleeves rolled up, guys, with nothing in my hands, if we can get a shot of this on the screen, I'm going to change this £50 note into the much rarer, infinitely more valuable Bank of Britain's Got Talent £50 note.
No way.
Now you can see we've got our head of state, Mr. Simon Cowell. We've got our beautiful princesses, of course, our queen. Simon, for you to keep. Don't spend it all at once. Guys, I don't want you to feel left out. So I brought along some more cash for you. But I know deep down, you don't really want one of these. You'd much rather have one of those Bank of Britain's Got Talent. One for each of you to keep.
Oh, I love that.
Thank you very much.
What?
Thought I'd finish with a trick using a picture that I've drawn. It's a self-portrait. That's me. This is where we are. Britain's Got Talent. You see, most magicians at this point would ask one of you to reach in and take a card. I'm not going to do that. Instead, if I may, I'm just going to ask each of you one question. David, if I may start with you. If I could ask you to choose a colour, red or black, whatever you say is what we will use. What colour would you like?
Black.
Black. Alicia, the black cards are split into two suits. We have the spades, we have the clubs. Again, if I could ask you to choose, whatever you want is what we will use.
Clubs.
Clubs. Fantastic. Amanda, I need you to choose a value for me. What would you like?
Nine.
Nine. The nine of clubs. Simon, you're the boss. I'm going to give you the chance, if you like, to stick with the nine of clubs, or you can overrule all of the other judges and you can choose any other card that you like. What would you like?
Seven of hearts.
The seven of hearts. Okay. Guys, there is no way I could know that you would choose the nine of clubs. There's no way I would know if you would overrule, and if you would, what you would change to. You'll agree I haven't touched these. What I didn't tell you is that I've also drawn on the back of every single other card in this deck. Do you remember those cartoon flip books where you flick through and the little man comes to life? Check this out. You see our magician. He takes off his hat. He reaches inside. He pulls out just one card, ladies and gentlemen. Not just any card, it's the Seven of Hearts.
I know this sounds crazy, but I now actually believe in magic. I do. Like some people believe in ghosts, I now believe in magic, because there's no explanation for that.
None whatsoever. Alicia?
Oh, my goodness. Honestly, that is going to bug us for the rest of the day, how you did that. You are incredible. I feel like we are witnessing the beginning of something special with you.
Bless you.
David?
I mean, that is a world-class trick. That's one of the best magic tricks I've ever seen. And
it's not a trick.
It's real magic. Yeah. He has magical powers.
Somebody once said to me, who I really respect, that there are a lot of people who do tricks and there are a few people who actually can do magic. And I think we just saw that.
Could you make Simon disappear?
We're going to take a vote. David?
Of course, yes!
It's a yes from me.
It's a yes from me.
You've got four yeses. Congratulations. I now believe.
Come on!
We'll hug it out.
Well done, pal.
Now, tell me what's about to happen.
I'll go underwater. The lid will be closed and padlocked shut. A chain will be wrapped around my neck. My hands will be handcuffed on the outside of the box. The lock around my neck and the handcuffs I'll be attempting to pick using a lock pick. But the last lock, the one that keeps the lid closed, that one's a little different. So I'm going to invite Ant and Dec on stage, if you would, please. Can we have a round of applause? Here on the table, I have a glass. It contains 20 keys. None of these keys will open that lock. Now, we don't have time to go through all 20, so take three or four at random, try them in the lock. When you've tried them, drop them in the glass, please. I have one more key. This is the one that opens the lock. Would you try that in the lock now, please? As he's doing that, would you put all the keys in the glass?
Yes.
Would you take the key out and put it in the glass with the 20 that don't?
Like that?
Yes. Now put your hand on top and shake up the keys.
Oh, he's nuts.
Oh my God.
The last lock is like trying to find a needle in a haystack. Thank you so much. Ladies and gentlemen, judges, Ant and Dec.
Now tell me, what should we be looking out for? Is this a period of time or what?
I'm gonna try and do it in a minute and a half, but if we start getting up around a minute 40, minute 50 underwater, holding my breath, then we're starting to have problems. If I start floating and I pass out, then you get me out.
Okay, yeah. Got it. Good luck.
Thank you.
I mean, this is crazy.
I actually feel sick already.
Yeah. These are the acts that actually can go wrong.
You're Callum, Jade's brother. Are you okay?
Yeah.
Oh, well, tell us a little bit about yourself, please.
I'm 26, I'm from Hull, and I'm singing a cover of a song by Robin.
I love Robin.
Yeah. It's Dancing on My Own, but it's a bit slower.
Okay, whenever you're ready, good luck.
Thank you.
Somebody said you got a new friend. And does she love you better than I can? And there's a big black sky over my town. I know it, I bet she's around. Stilettos and broken bottles, I'm spinning around in circles. And I'm in the corner watching you kiss her. Oh, oh, oh. And I'm right over here. Why can't you see me? Oh, oh, oh. And I'm giving it my all, but I'm not the guy. Far away, but still so near. The lights come on, the music dies, but you don't see me standing here. I just came to say goodbye. I'm in the corner watching you kiss her. Oh, and I'm giving it my all. The music dies, but you don't see me standing here.
Well done, Paul. Well done.
Thank you so much.
Oh my God, Simon!
Callum!
Welcome to Britain's Got Talent.
It's a pleasure to be here.
Well, that's very nice of you to say. So what are your names, boys?
My name's Charlie.
And my name's DeAndre. And together we're Baz and Melody. Bam.
What's the dream with you two guys?
I just want to deliver it to you people. I just want to give an awesome performance.
I get ya. What does your mum and dad do for a job?
My mum is a personal trainer and my father's a stonemason.
Stonemason!
Yeah, bro!
And you?
My mum's a cook in a school.
Dinner lady, yo!
And, my stepdad, he owns his own company.
He's a businessman, yeah!
Can I just say one thing? Alicia, I love you so much. You're my inspiration.
He fancy Alicia. He don't like Amanda.
Amanda, you're beautiful as well.
He is lying.
Boys, can I just ask you, what are you singing?
Well, it's Hope by Twista and Faith Evans, but it's a bit of a twist in the rap because I wrote it myself.
What's the song about?
It's about anti-bullying. So,
anti-bullying?
Yeah, because it's something that I feel deep about, so... I started rapping because I went through a very hard time in primary school. I was getting bullied.
As a parent, it's one of the hardest things to see your child upset and going through emotional turmoil. It is hard, very hard.
When I used to be, like, down in the dump, I used to write down my raps. I could express myself through what I was writing down.
I was very happy with the way Leandre dealt with it. He actually stood up to the bully and resolved the situation.
I moved school and it's a much better environment for me. I love school. I really do love school, it's amazing.
I'm very proud of him, very proud.
The first time we met, we really clicked. It was just an automatic connection. Like, I didn't think it'd be like that.
We're brothers.
I think music's made him a lot stronger. If it wasn't for his music, he wouldn't be as confident and as cheeky, you know? It just helps him a lot.
We really want people to listen and hear our lyrics that are in our song.
OK, good luck.
Thank you. God, I feel so alone. I'm just a kid, how can I take it on my own? I'm crying too many tears, yeah, writing this song. Trying to fit in, where do I belong? I wake up every day, don't want to leave my home. My mama's asking me, but I'm always alone. Too scared to say, too scared to holler. I'm walking to school with sweat around my collar. I'm just a kid, I don't want no stress. My nerves are bad, my life's a mess. The nature call me, they hurt real bad. I want to tell my mom, she's having trouble with my dad. I feel so trapped, there's nowhere to turn. Come to school, don't want to fight, I want to learn. So please, Mr. Bully, tell him what I've done. You know I have no dad, I'm living with
just
my mom.
Hopeful, yes I am. Hopeful for today. Take this music and use it. Let it take you away.
I like these two.
I do. Hopeful, hopeful, and he'll make a way. I know it ain't easy, but that's okay, just be hopeful.
Why do you trip back a tingle day? I didn't ask to be born, but now I have to pay. I ain't got no money, you take all I have. When I give it to you, I search for my bags. I feel so scared when you shout me down. You kick me, punch me, throw me to the ground. When I ask you, yo, what have I done? You hit me again, I make fun of my mom.
I'm hopeful, yes I am. Yeah. Hopeful for today, take this music.
Check it out.
Use it, let it take you away. And be hopeful. Hopeful, and he'll make a way. I know it ain't easy, but that's okay, just be hopeful.
What I wear is all I have. No. We lost a home, I'm living from a bag. Yo, Mr. Bully, help me please. I'm flesh and blood, accept me please. Hey, Mr. Bully, I don't know what to do. My mind, I can't explain what I did to you. Mr. Bully, take a moment please. Every single day, you bring me to my knees.
Hopeful, yes I am. Hopeful for today. Take this music and use it. Let it take you away. And be hopeful,
yeah.
Hopeful, and he'll make a way. I know it ain't easy, but that's okay, just be
whole. Oh. so much.
Seems like we hardly need to critique you, went so well, but let's have some comments. Amanda.
I'm just so happy for you. Your voice is beautiful. We all were in tears. So well done.
Thank you so much, thank you.
The minute you started that verse, it actually brought a tear to my eye. And it was really, really moving.
Alicia, if it weren't for you, I wouldn't be rapping, so, yeah, thank you so much.
Oh, that's really sweet.
For two young kids like yourself to come out and sing about something that really affects you, do it in a style that's completely yours, is a really rare thing. That's why you got that golden buzzer today.
Thank you so much.
Well, you know what? I've heard some monstrous songs today, and I just was literally losing the will to live. You know what? I listen to every word. Did this stuff happen in your life?
I got bullied a bit when I was younger, but...
But not anymore?
Yes, it's all gone now, yeah.
I think that record could be a hit, I really do. I really, really like you too.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
That's it. We'll see you in the live show.
Thank you. Hello.
Hi.
Hi. Hi, how are you?
I'm fine, thanks. How are you?
Good, nice to meet you. What's the act called?
Charlotte and Jonathan.
Charlotte and Jonathan. Okay. How old are you both?
I'm 16.
And I'm 17.
Okay. And you thought the combination would work. Whose idea was it?
It was our singing teacher's, actually. She thought it'd be good to try us out together. And we both sounded quite good when we sang what we did.
Okay, you're not saying much, Jonathan. Are you shy?
Sometimes. I've always had sort of problems with my size since I can remember. And when I was in sort of primary school, it was back then really that I had sort of the mick taken out of me, and it kind of damaged my confidence quite a bit. When people would say something to me, it'd just take a little piece out of me in a sense.
I'm quite protective of Jonathan. Like, if I was there and someone stood there and said something to him, I couldn't sit there with my mouth shut. Before you make a judgment on someone, I think you really need to get to know them. It's not. As cliche as it's not judging a book by its cover, you've got to read what's inside.
Charlotte's been a really big help for me in terms of confidence and making me a better performer, and I really don't think I'd be going up on stage today if I didn't have Charlotte by my side.
And do you think you could win?
Yeah, together.
All right, good luck.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Here we go.
Child needs to find a way.
God. Alicia?
It's not very often that that happens, that you can move an audience like that. You sing beautifully together. It was world class.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
A pop voice and an opera voice together. It was incredible.
OK, this is what I think. As Charlotte, I think you're good, but Jonathan, you are unbelievable. Seriously? Wow. You have an outstandingly good voice.
Thank you very much.
How old are you?
17.
I mean, that's unbelievable. Jonathan, you are a future star.
Thank you.
I like the fact that this works as a duo, but I worry, Charlotte, whether you're going to hold him back.
Well, we've come on here as a duo, and we're going to stay here as a duo.
Okay, David, we better vote. Yes or no?
Ah, such an easy decision. Yes.
Thank you.
Definitely a yes from me.
Charlotte, I think your voice complements Jonathan's really well, so don't be disheartened. It's a yes from me.
You know, my head here would say to you, Jonathan, dump her. And then my heart would say there was something kind of magical at moments together as well. So I'm going to say yes to the two of you. You've got four yeses.
Well done! Well done,
Corbyn. He's like a young Pavarotti, that boy. Yeah. I haven't heard a voice like that in years. No,
to be that young and that good.
Simon's a massive fan of you, isn't he?
Seems like it, yeah.
That is the biggest response we've had today.
Well.
Oh, my God.
Oh. Well done, my pal. You think it could be life-changing?
Life-changing? Well, yeah, to be honest.
I think for you.
Yeah.
I'm Natalie and I'm 10 years old and I love to sing. Some kind of superstar. I've been singing ever since I was 4. I sing at school, I sing at home. I sometimes sing when I'm eating my dinner. I would like to be a singer and a diva and I definitely want to be like Beyonce.
Good luck, little white moth. Good luck, have fun.
Hello, darling.
Hello.
Could you be any cuter?
What's your name and how old are you?
My name's Natalie and I'm 10 years old.
Okay. And what are you doing today?
Well, I'm gonna sing a song called No One from Alicia Keys.
Okay, yeah, I know that one.
Does she sing all the time?
Yes.
Yeah. What, it drives you crazy?
Yes.
You've had enough? Oh, I see you're trying to palm her off on us now, is that what it is?
Good luck, darling.
I just want you close. You can stay forever. You can be sure. Oh, oh.
getting up on their feet. A lot more clapping.
Can you tell me who you are, please?
We are Only Boys Allowed.
Only Boys Allowed?
Yeah.
And what are you?
We're a Welsh male vocal group from the Welsh Valleys.
We believe passionately in the tradition of male singing in Wales, and we want to make sure the tradition's there in 100 years' time.
OK, yeah. Fabulous. Well...
In this show for a really great choir, and you are that really great choir. It was fantastic.
Simon.
I have got a very, very good feeling about you lot. I really, really loved what you did. I've never heard that song before, but I absolutely love it. And I think you guys are amazing.
Alicia. 100%
yes.
David, yes or no?
Guys, of course, it's a yes.
Amanda?
It's a yes
Voices. What's your name?
Jay Wynn.
Doesn't sound very robot-y.
No.
Just sounds like a guy.
I'm a support worker.
Okay. Where are you from?
Gloucester.
You at least go Gloucester.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Give us a thumbs up. Oh, he hasn't got a thumb. Hit it.
Microchip on his shoulder. No, I love you, Simon, I'm joking.
I'm going to kick this off with a no.
Okay.
It's unique. I'm going to say yes.
We're in Blackpool. We're kicking off the show. I am saying yes.
I'm going to say yes.
Well done, Jay.
Nice. Bye, Paul.
And you, nice to meet you too.
Wow, once again,
you... Oh, God! Really, what are we going to do?
Right, we're looking for the last act here from the auditions.
Who's it, Sue? Sue. We're looking for Sue, who was the final auditionee of 2017.
Sue!
Sue!
Sue, last act. We need the last act on stage. Sue. Is there Sue there? Any acts there? Nope.
Don't rain on my parade.
Don't tell me not
oh
to
my
lift
God.
Your sun. Life's
candy and the sun's a
oh, she sneak on.
Sir. Yeah. Don't tell me not to fly. I've simply got to. If someone takes a spill
of oh, there she is,
hi, Sue.
At least I didn't fake it. Hot sir, I guess I'm a cat. So whether I'm the rose of sheer perfection, a freckle on the nose of life's complexion, a cinder or the shiny apple of his eye, I've got to fly once, I've got to try once, only can die once, right sir? Ooh, life is juicy, juicy, and you'll see I gotta have my bite. Live and live now. Get what I want. I know how. One roof of the whole shebang. One throw that bell will go clang. I am the target. Oh well. One shot, one gunshot. A bam!
Can't beat him, join him.
Go on then.
Half a mil of Casama Kama. I simply gotta march my heart to drum and no. Body, no, no.
Yeah.
Yes, end the term fever.
What's your name?
My name's Sue, Alicia.
Nice to meet you, Sue. Where are you from?
I'm from Clayton Le Moors near Accrington in Lancashire. You're just a good
time. Do you have a day job?
I'm a singer.
You're brilliant.
Oh, thank you.
I don't know what you did to us, but you made David strip.
I know. Woo!
You're one of those people, you made us all so happy. Yeah. We all just wanted to join in like a lot of the best performers.
It was a very, very fitting end to Britain's Got Talent 2017. You were fantastic.
Simon.
I'm traumatised. I literally can't get this thought out of my mind, what I just saw. I'm really sorry. You know what? That was a great entrance. The fact that you carried on with all the nuttiness.
Last audition of the series, and you made it worthwhile, right? Shall we take a vote, guys? I'll kick this off with a yes. Thank you.
I'm saying yes.
I'm saying yes.
I'm not saying yes to you, but I'm saying yes to you. Congratulations.
What a great end. Kiss a kiss.
Well, what a way to end the night.
What was that?
Did you see that?
The quiz.
Just there.
Welcome. What's your name, please?
It's Elizabeth.
Elizabeth.
Just Elizabeth.
Why have you come on Britain's Got Talent?
Because I want to show you something special and try and make the impossible possible.
Well, the stage is yours, Elizabeth.
Theatres of London's West End, it's said to be haunted by many ghosts. In 1919, the great Harry Houdini appeared on stage and offered a large cash sum for anyone who could prove the existence of them. Amanda, I'd like you to take this journal in your left hand and I'd like you to come with me.
I'm scared.
Legends have said that spirits departed walk the halls and stores of the theatres of London. It is said to be good luck to see ghosts for a performer. For others, not so much.
Look scared.
Oh my God. Where are we going?
That's under the stage.
Amanda, please take a seat. These photographs are of people who have lived and died over 100 years ago.
I'm kind of creeped out.
Can you hold out your left hand like this? Now, in a moment, I want you to count these photographs face down onto the table, one at a time. When you place them down, you're going to feel a connection to one. When you feel that connection, I want you to stop and to place that photograph face down into this cigar box. Look at the photographs. Each and every one is different. But you were drawn to one, and you don't know why.
No.
Open the cigar box and take out the photograph that you chose. Turn it over and read out what it says.
Agatha Turner, 1860.
Before this all began, I gave you a journal that's over 100 years old. Open the page I've bookmarked and read out the paragraph that I've circled in red.
Miss Turner was born in the 1800s. She loved visiting the West End to be entertained. She tragically died in 1860, and her ghost is said to haunt the theatres that she once loved.
Amanda, this moment was always meant to be. Look over your left shoulder.
Oh my God!
My name is Keiji Iwasaki.
Where are you from?
I'm from Japan.
Oh, I love Japan.
Ah, thank you so much.
Watashi wa arigatou.
Oh, yes, exactly.
Yes.
Oh, this is...
That's all I know. how old are you?
Yeah, I'm 49 years old.
And what you're doing for us today, is that your day job?
No, it's my bicycle and... No. Sorry. Pardon. I'm a little bit nervous, so excuse me.
No worries, my darling. So why Britain's Got Talent?
It's because a big stage, the biggest stage in the world, then it's like one of my dreams to come here.
Oh, fantastic.
Yes, it's amazing.
Wow, it's a pleasure to have you. Yeah. And what would you do with the money if you were to win?
I want to across the Atlantic Ocean by rowing a boat, so then I want to buy the boat.
Oh, fabulous.
You didn't expect that answer, did you?
No one's ever said that.
I love that. Yeah.
Okay, well, whenever you're ready,
yes,
go for it.
Okay, now I start.
Yeah. Oh, my God, I love him.
I'm laughing already.
Simon, hello. How are you? Because 100 times I saw you in YouTube. Hey, Simon, do you know this one?
Chopstick.
Yes, chopstick. One, two, three. Sorry. One more time. Just this.
What did you just do?
It's not the magic. I'm joking. Let's start the magic.
He's good. He's funny.
Then maybe ask the Deccan the aunt.
Deccan.
Yes.
Deck it, that's right.
Please check this card is normal.
Normal.
And please shuffle it.
Of course.
Yes,
very well. Deck shuffle the
deck.
Shuffled by Deccanant.
Yes. Please take one card as you like.
Me?
Yeah, no. Next to that.
Still me.
No. Okay, please show everybody. I don't see it. I don't want to see it. Okay, please show the audience.
No, I'm doing this bit.
Okay, may I put it here? And I just scroll. Now I show the Japanese way to suffering. Okay?
Wada, wada.
Here, your card is wada. There. The queen, this or this?
No, that's not.
This one?
No, no.
No, no, what? I'm still just going to hear it. It's a good news, you can.
Yeah.
Wow. How do you put the pod in the man's armpit?
No, I put... Just move. It's a boy, man.
Stop!
Now, I was like this, hop, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
Amazing! Oh.
Didn't know Japan was creating wizards. What's going on over here?
£20.
And do you want it?
No.
I put here, £20. Hop, what? Excuse me, energy finished, but no problem. Genki dama! My last trick is for ladies.
For ladies?
Yes. Alicia, do you come over here?
I come over here.
Well,
you didn't do an awful lot then, did you?
He didn't ask us to, did he?
Alicia, what? Okay, arigato. Please check this is what? What is this?
It's a ring.
It's a ring, yes. Give me a finger like this. I put the ring here. Okay, just hold on, don't move, because it's a very difficult magic. This ring, your finger. Hat, 1, 2, 3. All star passing. Whoa! I said, wait, hold on. Hat, 1.
You are very, very charming, and your magic was absolutely excellent.
Yes.
I mean,
it's more
faultless.
Than so much. It's too much.
You're the funniest person we've seen, and the most magical person we've seen, all combined in one, and I love you.
Yes, thank you so much.
You are an absolute natural.
People are going to like you so much.
Thank you so
My son
much.
Is going to love you. I mean, love you. You are one of the best we've seen so far.
Isn't that lovely?
Yes, thank you so much.
The audience love you. I love you too. You're a superstar, so I'm going to kick this off with a yes.
Yes, thank you so much.
It's a yes from me.
It's a yes from me.
No. You, my friend, get a golden buzzer.
That's so good, isn't it?
dreams. Thank you so much. I can't explain my emotion. I never expected Gordon Brothers. It's too much. Thank you so much. You did it!
Thank you! Oh, you were brilliant!
That's brilliant!
I love him so much!
I know, me too! It's like a dream! I saw this in like YouTube, some people got Gordon
Brothers! Yeah! Like, yeah. And now it's you!
Yes! I'm going crazy!
Right!
Oh my God, so cute!
You're joking, it's my mum! You're joking! You got it
in. Who have we got here? Hello.
Callie. Savannah.
And are you sisters? And who have you brought with you today?
Nanny.
So is she your mummy's mummy or your daddy's mummy?
Daddy's mummy.
Okay, brilliant. And can I ask Savannah, how old are you?
3.
Amazing. And Callie, how old are you?
4.
Oh.
Cute.
What are we here for?
To surprise Dad.
What's going on?
Well, Nick doesn't know anything about it, and we're surprising him because we want him to come and sing, because he sings a lovely song for the girls. Oh. Come along, Nick.
I've just seen him.
Come on, Nick.
Come on, Nick.
You can't believe it.
Oh, my goodness me.
Oh, wow.
You just thought you were having a lovely day out.
I did. We had a whole day planned.
Well, that's changed.
Yeah, this is complete shock to me.
He said he'd never do it, so we had to do it for him.
Why did you say you'd never do it?
I think over the years, I've lost a lot of confidence in my singing. So, I tend to do it at home, in the shower. You know?
Well, I'll tell you what, Nick, I'll tell you what, why don't you go off, grab a glass of water, and then come back on? Would that be a good idea?
Thank you.
Nick, literally thought you'd run away.
I noticed you've got your words down there, which is totally fine. Do whatever it takes to get through it.
It's a song that I felt quite attached to, so I sing it quite a lot around the house. So hopefully I'll keep the nerves and the crying away whilst I'm singing it.
Bless you. Yeah. Well, we are all rooting for you, aren't we?
Thank you.
Dancing in the living room and
drawing on the table, wearing mama's pearls, putting on her makeup. Even though I know these moments, they won't last forever. And to me, you'll always be daddy's little girls. Someday you'll be dressed in white, all gracious with butterflies. But in my mind I'll let you go. In my heart you know you'll always stay. But until then I cherished every kiss goodnight, and every door you slam and every little fight. I'll be there for you even when I'm gone. You'll just listen to this song like nothing's changed at all. You're still daddy's little girls, precious little angels, dancing in the living room and drawing on the table, wearing mama's pearls, putting on her makeup. Even though I know these moments, they won't last. To me, you'll always be, yeah, to me, you'll always be, you're still daddy's little girl.
Yeah, I'm fine.
It was so sweet. You got a nice voice.
You have such a beautiful voice. It's just, it was a really, really lovely surprise. What did you think, David?
Well, it was just so moving from start to finish, and you know, just looked like you were going to burst into tears every word, actually, but yeah, I felt like there's not a dry eye in the house, and that really hit me emotionally more than anything else today.
Well, it was absolutely gorgeous. Me and Alicia are in bits.
We have to vote. I'm going to say yes.
It's a yes from me.
It's a yes from me.
Well, I think you've got 4,004 yeses.
I get to love you. I get to love you.
Oh, well done, Nick.
I get to love you. I get to
thank you.
Love
like it.
I'm just going to grab something from over here. Oh. Amanda, please hold the balloon by the stick. Balloons are the first thing that we all learn to lose. Like the child that that lost this balloon earlier today. They thought it was a gust of wind. It wasn't. It was me. I stole it to teach a lesson in loss. You might think it was rather mean to burst a balloon like that, but losing things is an important part of life. I'll show you what I mean. Amanda, the box on this trolley is the theatre's lost property box. Please open the lid. Without showing anyone, Amanda, you will take one of the items and place it under the cloth on the trolley. Being invisible means I can't have material possessions of my own. So, instead, I just steal them from other people. And better yet, I can compel other people to do my bidding. Alicia, reach in with your right hand. Take a random object and hold it so no one can see what you chose. You are holding a secret in your hands. One that nobody could possibly know. Remember, you could have taken anything from that box, and yet Amanda knows exactly what you have taken.
Joy!
Amanda, I want you to take a deep breath and tell everyone what Alicia is holding in her right hand.
A dummy. No way.
This is weird.
But there's just one object left to identify. The one that you took at the beginning, Amanda. There is a piece of chalk on the trolley. Please pick it up and bring it to me over here. I'm standing in front of the blackboard. And let go of it, Amanda. I will take it from here.
How is it doing that?
Amanda, please lift the cloth and show everyone what you put there. Please keep hold of those keys and take them back to your seat. You see, I've been amongst you these last few days. It's just that no one ever saw me.
Scary act.
I don't like it.
Between the dark and the light, the good and the evil, which will you choose?
Oh, dear.
Oh, no, they're done with
anything. Oh, no, is it coming out? I don't like it.
Don't come down here.
Careful, Simon.
Oh, there are two pathways for you, David.
Yes?
Which do you choose? Take an apple. Take a bite.
Mmm. It's nice.
Mmm. Your turn, Alicia. Between the good and the evil, which will you choose? Take an apple. Bitey bite. There's something I've got to tell you, but it can wait. It can wait. Amanda, stand up.
Me.
Your hands out. Face up. Come closer. Come closer. There we are. Your destiny will be chosen by another.
Oh, God.
Between the dark and the light. Only choose. Right. Louder!
Right.
Who's right, though?
My right!
Take a bite. Amanda.
Yeah?
You know why they say the beauty's only skin deep? Because we're all rotten to the core!
Okay, well, that was horrific.
Oh, I can't.
And the witch has turned into a cockroach. So we're gonna have to talk to them.
I mean, I was scared to death. I mean, I'd quite like to see what else was gonna happen.
I'm with you.
In the future.
Alicia, what do you think?
I thought the act was actually brilliant.
David.
I thought it was stunning. So I think we should vote, and let me kick this off with a yes!
I'm saying yes!
Amanda.
It's a yes from me.
We want to see you in the next round. I don't know how you did that. Maybe we'll see you in the finals. Congratulations.
It's freaking me out. Did I come back? He or she?
So terrifying.
Welcome. What's your name?
My name's Lauren.
And where are you from?
From Brooklyn, New York.
Is that right?
Yes.
So why Britain's Got Talent?
Most of my favorite singers are from the UK, so I thought I'd come pay a visit to you guys.
Okay. So Lauren, tell me a bit about you.
I think some of you guys have actually heard my voice, but you don't know my face. I sang the song Never Enough on The Greatest Showman.
No. Oh, my God!
Oh, my God!
Blew their minds!
Oh, my God!
So I was hired to do the reference vocals for the actresses so they could learn the songs. And so they had me come in and sing Never Enough. And it really was Rebecca Ferguson, who plays Jenny Lind, who said, I think that Lauren should sing the song, and I'll lip sync.
So you sang one of the biggest songs of all time. You've now revealed it wasn't the actress who sang the song in the movie. It was you singing that song. So why didn't you get that big deal after the song?
I was more comfortable singing behind the scenes, but I feel kind of like the song was meant for me, and I'm kind of ready to put a face to the song. So I'm here to do that.
Are you going to sing that tonight?
Yes.
Such a great thing to watch.
Good luck.
Brace, girl.
I'm trying to hold my breath. Let it stay this way. Can't let this moment end. I set off a dream in me, getting loud now. Can you hear it echoing? Take my hand. Will you share this with me? 'Cause darling, without you, all the shine of a thousand spotlights, all the stars we steal from the night sky will never be enough, never be enough. Towers of gold are still too little. These hands can hold on.
Never, 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 never.
It's like the bucket list of the Super Saiyans.
I am absolutely shaking. I can't believe I've had this incredible opportunity to give you your moment to shine, because this is it.
We were just in palm of your hand from like the first note. I can't think there's been many experiences on the show where we've ever had that feeling.
Well, it feels like a superstar's arrived. Like it was, it transcended, it was otherworldly.
This is so well deserved, because seeing somebody else sing that song in that movie and not have the recognition of doing one of the most incredible vocals ever. And now, for you to kind of reveal yourself to the world, it was actually one of the most incredible audition moments I've ever experienced. I'm speechless.
Thank you.
I'm so happy. Timing in life is everything, and maybe this is your moment now. Congratulations.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you.